Nothing we couldn't take. Well, you are the right kind of guys. You, the Colonel, Duke, that guy did a swell job on that bridge. He was a great guy. May he rest in peace. Yeah. So, what did I want to say? Yes. Thank you. You people accepted me, and I'm a simple guy. I will pay that debt back, okay? So, how do you like it out here after your tunnels? Freedom, huh? Sure thing. So much space. It feels too empty to me, though. Just reeds and ruins and those damn mutants. Hate them. Phew. Now you guys are gonna see the government. So, Bratuha, don't be mad, but just tell me, what the hell do you even need them for? Well, of course, it might be interesting to take a look, but throughout all of my rambling, I only met two kinds of ex-government people. Dead ones and gang leaders. And let me tell you, the latter are much worse than your typical bandit. They just have to make a speech before doing something awful. So what I mean is, I didn't really care about the government even before the war, much less now, when everything's long since gone to shit. So what for, really? I'm a simple man, and tell me, I told I'm with you, that means I'm with you for the long haul. But I'd much rather find a nice place to live at than go see the government. Of course, they could give us luxury bunkers or something. Well, Artyom, you seem cold. Go get warmed up a bit, I'll smoke some more. I've stuff to think about. Or just stay, we have enough space now.
Well, I have stuff to do too. You guys are fast to break gear, but none too expedient to fix it.
So you're back. What other plans does our leader have in store? Wait, don't tell me.
Putting on a live performance here.
Here's one of my favorites.
Thank you, Stepan.
I'm sorry to ask, Katya, but Nastya's father, he's dead, isn't he? Does Nastya know?
He is. I tried keeping it a secret. Told her he left for the market. Around 3 days passed, and I still kept it in. I just sat there with a needle in my hand and didn't see anything. It was all black before my eyes. And then she snuggles up to me and says, "You should cry, Ma. You will feel better." Sini used to say it. So I cried and cried. She knows. She knows it all.
I'm sorry, Katya. I'm so sorry.
Let me tell you how we ended up at the bridge. We used to live in northeast from here, Quite close if you go in a straight line. But it took us a month. Everything's bombed to rubble out there. Yermak asked me and I told him. Sini used to say there are lots of military factories out there. Not just military, of course. General industry. And now you can't pass through there even with filters. The radiation is so high. No railway either, just crater upon crater. We were quite far, but our counters still
Look,
went crazy.
Stop with this funeral mood! It is Duke we are talking about. Do you recall how he came back from the library?
The colonel's waiting for you on the bridge.
Same thing here!
Well, yeah, that time he pulled a fast one on us. We had the drinks ready. Sam said everything. Was a good speech, too.
Thanks.
Well, that is true. Don't be shy. So, Sam ends his speech, and then Duke asks, where's my drink?
So that is why I say we should wait. He came back from that library. And this is nothing. We will pick him up on our way back.
If we live to go back.
No, come on!
Well, I just think we should still drink to Duke's memory. And if he's alive, that's only a good omen. Sam, what do you say?
I'll drink later. Gotta finish cooking.
Okay. Let's drink!
All right, let's!
Oh, that's rough.
Yeah, kinda rough.
By the way, speaking of omens, let's have a service for him once we come across another church.
Duke didn't believe, and having met Salantius, I'm also wavering.
Well, Salantius' god is definitely a lost cause. But I imagine Duke would like Valhalla. A paradise where fallen heroes spend eternity feasting and fighting. A good fit for all of the people we lost.
Yes, this is worth having another drink for. To our guys having fun in Valhalla! There's something I've been thinking about. What does everyone expect of this trip? Duke used to say that he just couldn't spread his wings back home. He was too eager to win that girl over with heroics. He thought that outside he'd have space for that.
And why did you come?
Thanks to Tokarev, he got the decoder working.
Ark, come in. Come in, Ark. Over.
Hey, this is Ark. Identify yourself. Over.
This is Colonel Svyatoslav Myonnikov speaking. I'm in command of a special operations force. We have received your signal and are currently heading your way. Do you copy? Over.
Yes. Yes. I hear you loud and clear.
Who am I talking to? How do I address you?
The Deputy Chief of Communications Department, Major Ivanov. A moment.
Oh, yes, Major. I understand that a checkup is in order.
Great, Colonel. Melnikov? Simply capable. I am sorry for the lack of trust, but as you know, the situation is dire, and the enemy is always ready to strike.
I do understand, Major, and I hope that you can tell the leadership that my people are true to their duty and will be at their full disposal as soon as we arrive. Over.
Thank you for the great news. How large is your force, Colonel?
I have a squad aren't a large force, but we bring a message of extreme importance. We are heading towards you from Sector K6 Alpha. If you have any data on enemy forces, we might encounter on the way. Over.
Just a moment, I have to check. K6 Alpha, you say? As far as I can see, there have been no enemy encounters reported in the area, Colonel. I regret. I must end our conversation here, but know that we are waiting for your arrival. I am making my report immediately, and I am sure the Minister of Defense will be eager to see you.
This is a great honor. Thank you. Just a few words more, though. What is the general situation, Major? Please.
Colonel, sir, you do understand this is classified information.
But I do understand you.
We are doing fine. Do not worry.
Well, see you in the Ark. Over and out. I serve the people. Over and out.
So, do you get this now, you doubting Thomas? I'm so excited, my hands are still shaking. The Minister himself! This is incredible! By the way, Artyom, you should take a look at the map. As you can see, we're heading almost straight for the Yamantau complex. Katya and Chris tell me that the line there is in decent condition. Surprising, really, taking into account the number of priority targets there. So, we can hope for smooth sailing from here, and right to the very destination. It's not even that far, but our speed depends on the state of the track. So, I think it's gonna take us quite some time to get there. So, Yermak, where were we?
You were saying, it's all about the results!
Ah, yes. These soft-bellied attitudes must stop.
We are approaching the Yamantau bunker, the final destination of our long journey. Direct radio contact with the bunker has completely dissolved Miller's resentment towards me for destroying our previous lives. He is eagerly anticipating the meeting with the Minister of Defense he was promised. Probably such things are important for a career officer. The people, though, are less interested. They are asking important questions. Where are the occupying forces? Why is there just wilderness and people gone wild around? What's stopping the government from restoring the country? What was being done in the last 20 years? Miller believes that we'll get all the answers. He will be pardoned, as well as Anna and I. And we will all return home to the Metro.
Leaving me behind? Am I your daughter or not?
All right, come with us, or else I'll never hear the end of it.
A wise decision.
Yermak, stop the engine. the Aurora back to the safe zone and keep tight there.
We'll do that right now.
Stepan, you're in charge while I'm away.
Sir, yes, sir.
Great. Let's go. Worse than Moscow.
Yeah, looks like it. See that crater? Wonder what the yield was on that one. Looks like a hundred to me. Lucky. Your guys used to have 3 and 500 ones too.
Well, even 100 seems to have done okay.
Place. Now we shouldn't have come here, really.
Okay, so where's my welcoming committee in red carpet? I don't get this.
Oh, see? Nobody home. How about we go back, huh? Hey.
Look!
Identify yourself.
Colonel Miller, here to report to the Minister of Defense.
And where are your people, Colonel?
With the train.
It's dangerous outside. Contact them and tell them to take the train into the main airlock for decontamination. Welcome to the Ark, Colonel. Proceed through the tunnel and take the elevator. You'll be met inside.
Reporting to the minister is no joke.
Ah, get off my case. I pulled an all-nighter.
Don't you feel like you should say something to Artyom now?
Yes. You were right, Artyom. And I was wrong. Thanks for not giving up. Come
Cyprian Minister, Commander of the Joint Special Operations Forces Squadron of the City of Moscow, Colonel Miller, reporting. I would like to request that my people are provided with temporary quarters and supplies, as there are women and children among us. Still, our fighters are in top shape and ready for action.
Women and children? Good. Haven't had those in a while.
Who are you?
Everything is going as planned. Everyone is fine. So far.
So far? I demand a meeting with the Minister of Defense now!
Do not worry. Everything will be just fine. And even better. The Minister and the Chief himself are expecting you for dinner.
Dinner? What the hell? Are you fucking mocking me?
Shut up! The doctor is talking.
Where is the government? Answer!
All here, Colonel. All here. We are the government you people deserve.
Don't you dare, you fuck! You're just fucking cannibals!
Calm down, we'll get jaundice like this. And believe me, nobody likes that bitter taste. The girl will have to wait, though. We must run the tests first. I don't like that cough of hers.
Untie my hands, you motherfucker! And I'll shove those tests so far up your ass, you'll be spitting
them! Watch your tone, young lady. Do as that young man does. He woke up long ago, but quietly listens to wise people talk.
You fucker! Let me go!
Not a single!
So, Colonel, now you will pick up the radio and tell the rest of your people on the train to come here. If you don't want her to suffer for a really long time before she is served. Do you understand? And here I was hoping for an intelligent conversation for a change. Alas. That's not a problem, though, since this nice young man will surely do it instead. He won't dare be contradictory once we're done with you. Well, nice meeting you and all. Yakov, you may start.
I'll get you even after I'm dead.
That may well happen, Colonel. I could choke on you or something. In the meantime, I'll excuse myself.
Come here! I'll rip you all apart! Every last one of you should have done that before the war! But I'll get you now!
Long
burn this car to ashes! So that not even the dirtiest bones are
dead! Now we'll be fooled again! Good.
Here. Colonel, sir, I think that's
enough.
Thank
you, son. But it is not. We have to get them. But first, we must fight. To hell with it! Idiot! Start the main elevator off!
Elevator on the move, sir! Hold a minute!
Yes, sir!
Well done.
6. Even the lift is the same, exactly.
True, and quite fortunate. This way, we can hope to find Anna. Still, the complex is huge, and we have 10 minutes at the most. So, we'll have to split up. Sam, you check the filter room, the generator hall, and the storage. Idiot, you come with me to the command center. Artyom, you take the barracks and the sick bay.
Kid! They see me! It's meat!
Copy that. Continue search.
And that...
He's pinned down! Circle him!
I think it's out!
Artyom, I knew! Behind you!
There is always one like you, a hero! You're not saving anyone, just like the others! So just...
Freeze!
Yes, yes!
Let him go!
Don't kill me!
Now!
Remember what I told you, there was an
Enough chatter! Are you all right, Artyom? Thank God.
Ah!
Let's report to the Colonel. Dad, it's me.
Are you okay? Where are you?
In the sickbay. Artyom found me.